Hello there, guys, and welcome back to a brand new match review on my channel. It's Sweden 1, Spain 1. This is going to be an absolutely huge match review. I'm sorry if this gets a little bit long, but stick to it, because there's so much to discuss. Not only is this such a massive game in Sweden and Spain, our hardest game in the group, it was the game that we knew if we got a point, we went through, and we got that in the 91st minute through substitute striker Rodrigo Moreno. It was a mental moment. It really was a great moment on the sidelines. But aside from that, that is so much to talk about in this game. Positives, mainly negatives. There are things we need to pick up on here, guys. It's not looking good for the national team. We have to change it, and there is so much to talk about. So let's get to it. So if we just look at the table and how things are looking, you know, we came into the international break, I believe, 8 points above. I think we're now 5 points above the Sweden who are beneath us, but it's all right. It's plain sailing now. We are through. No matter what happens from here in, even if we're only top by 1 point or whatever, we will still be in the Euros. And what I will say for next international break is we've got Malta at home. We've got Romania at home. I just want two wins, and that will secure top spot. I really want top spot in this group. So this really isn't done yet. But there was also another really interesting result. That was Romania 1, Norway 1. That late Norway goal, the penalty, absolutely massive for Sweden, because Romania would have taken a second spot in the group and really could have pushed on from there. But next international break is going to be key to really define who's going to be coming top, third, second, and of course fourth. Malta and Faroe Islands kind of out of it right now, but there's still loads of spots up for grabs in this group. And if we just take a look at some of the newspapers for this game that have been coming out this morning, Mundo Deportivo, even the Barcelona newspaper, say to the Euros, so they seem positive about this one. So do Sport, another Barcelona newspaper. They say Euro Roja, so that's going to be another chance for Spain at the Euros. We've qualified, and Marca taking a more, you could say, pragmatic approach. You know, they're saying Menos Mal, which basically is a saying in Spain. It's almost like, thank goodness for that. And I would agree with that, really. I don't think it was a good performance from us, and we really got lucky with a late Rodrigo goal. Lineup-wise, this is where the video really starts to get interesting. Sweden, again, we predicted spot on. Lindelof came back into that defence. He looked good. And apart from that, they went in their 4-4-2 block and just sat in. Spain, however, again, hard to predict. We did all right this time. He went for De Gea in goal, actually, which was interesting. Went for Carvajal at right back. In defence, we predicted he would go for Albiol and Inigo Martinez. Left back stuck with Bernat. I felt that was harsh on Aguilon, but fair enough. In midfield, he picked Rodri over Busquets. Not really sure about that one. He went with Fabian and Thiago in there, which we also predicted. But again, guys, he was using Ceballos in what was kind of more of a left-wing position again. And then Gerard Moreno having his Spain debut with Oyarzabal on the right wing. So really interesting from Moreno. What I would say as a first positive this time is at least at the start of the game, it was more of a 4-1-2-1-2 diamond, which isn't the formation we should be using, but at least it meant that Ceballos could play in CAM and not in a left wing role. You know, he was a lot more central today, but again, he was ineffective. He lost the ball loads of times. He's clearly not comfortable in the role that high up the pitch. And for Moreno, he really, really needs to get it right. It's clear that he's not picking names. We get that. And we do respect that, but it is just getting to the extent where we're looking at the lineups and just thinking, what is that? What is that? That's just a Sweden-level lineup. We want to be Spain. We want to have top players in our teams. And I get there are injuries. I get there are suspensions. But honestly, Moreno could be doing so much better with the teams he's putting out there. He's just putting out names that, like, they're decent footballers. They've been having good spells for their clubs. But this is the Spanish national team, one of the most glorified teams in the whole of the world, really. Let's be honest. It's Spain, you know, the team that won the Euros, World Cup and Euros back-to-back. That is astonishing. And I think it's bringing players in like Inigo Martinez and like Raúl Albiol, who I don't think had particularly bad games, but these are the sort of players that are just bringing our level down, in my opinion, and we really need to get a pedigree back to our name. And Moreno needs to understand that. He needs to understand the magnitude of this job. He needs to understand that I agree with the fact that, you know, we need to be giving merit to the good performances for club level, but you need to only do it to a certain point. You know, we can't just be picking players just because they're playing well for their clubs. You need to think about, are they going to work in the national team? Are they the right player profile? And are they going to fit effectively in a 4-3-3 system, which a lot of these players certainly don't, and it's just not working right now. The names aren't good enough, and it's just not a Spain team. And Moreno is certainly under massive pressure right now. People are already calling for him to be leaving, and it's really worrying, because I went into the Norway game, I went into the Sweden game, and I said I'm excited. And I'm excited because these are the games that Spain usually crumble on, and they usually crumble on because they'll put up a block, and they're good enough for putting up a block. If Faroe Islands put up a block, we'll put four past them. But when good sides do it, well-drilled sides do it, which is who will be coming up against at the Euros in this summer, then it's hard to get through. And why I was excited because I thought Moreno had ways around it. I thought that he was going to play out this team like we did away to Romania. It was smart. It was clever tactics from Moreno. It really worked. We got him behind Romania on countless occasions, had about 20 attempts on that game, and they never really looked like threatening us. And even though we were in a 4-4-2 that game, he found a way around it. The personnel was better. Now he's picking the wrong personnel, the wrong squads, and the wrong shapes combined. And against Sweden and against teams like Sweden and Norway, we showed our true colours here at this international break. Really worrying, and it does almost take a little bit of the sting out of the Euros for Spain, with that back down to ground level, really. And I think the result last night and the result against Norway really epitomises where we are right now. And again, Sweden, they were at home, they know they could have really done with a win tonight, but again, they don't go to attack us because they know if they go to attack us, they're going to lose the game 2 or 3-0. But if they sit in their block, have about 20% possession at home, just let us pass sideways, then they will get over us at certain points of the game, and they did. You guys saw it if you watched it, or if you didn't. Sweden, they came onto us for little 10-minute periods, we couldn't get near them, they had more legs, they looked fitter, they looked sharper, because they had their system, and that's very, very easy to play against Spain, when you just put up a block, and then when you want to, you can break out, and then by then we don't react, we do not react, we don't close up the spaces, and even when they do create even when they do throw men forward, we don't create chances, we don't play quick enough on the counter attack. Actually, what we do is pass sideways until they're back in their block, so then we can have another 5-minute possession spell before an overhit pass. Really, that has to change. That is why I was excited for Moreno coming in. He looked like he was going to be bringing a new life to this national team, and I'm thinking, no, we're not just going to pass sideways, we're not just going to do what has happened at the last 3 major tournaments, we're going to try and find new and innovative ways in behind the back four. We saw that as he first came in, new set-piece tactics, they were catching teams off guard, it was giving us new alternatives. But all of a sudden, this international break, when it really mattered against two top-class sides, we really have crumbled here, we really have. Anyway guys, it's time for the match action. Sorry for all those negatives, but we really, really have to get over them. There's no good just saying, look at this, Spain are in the Euros, what a beautiful moment. Last minute goal, Moreno subs worked. No, it wasn't good. It wasn't good, and it wasn't good in the Norway game either. But anyway, match action. We started well. We did start well. I think that was because, as I mentioned, Ceballos were playing a little more centrally. Again, that left us with really no width and an unbalanced formation. Oyarzabal was coming wide right. And then if we looked to the left wing, there was literally no one there other than Bernat, who then got run over by the likes of Larsson and Lustig. Anyway, we started well. Fabian had a shot tipped over the bar in the 7th minute, or in the 2nd minute, sorry, in about the 7th or 8th minute, Thiago walked through the team. And then he has a chance to shoot, and ball rolls it. That was probably the most irritating moment of the first half. It was a clear chance for Thiago Alcantara, and he really should have scored, and it is sort of like him. You know, if he wants to do a pass, he'll do a flick. If there's a shot on, he'll do a ball roll. That's the sort of player he is. He does add that quality. He was often switching the play and getting us in a lot, Thiago, which is why I put him in the predicted lineup at the beginning. He does offer us a lot, but there's things like that that really make him an irritating and frustrating player, and he halted us back there in that game for sure. Moreno had a good header tip around the post too. Doherty had a shot from close range, bundled wide by Olsen, and if we're being honest, within the first 20 minutes, we should have been 2-0 up. We should have been 2-0 up, guys, but our legs went. Our legs completely went, and this was one of the moments in the game where Sweden got back into the game. If I'm being honest, De Gea kept us in it at certain points. They came back. There was a great header there by Kajson after a good cross by Larsson, I believe. Tipped over the post from De Gea. They got in a couple of times. They had another shot from Kajson on his left foot. We were conceding corners now. We couldn't really get the ball back. They were having large possession spells against us. Playing out the back was problematic, and at the end of the half, we managed to get it out and really clawed it back in the last 10-15 minutes. And it did end up going in at 0-0 despite a Fabian shot being deflected over the crossbar. But, you know, we had a good chance to make it a good, comfortable game in the first half. Didn't take it. We were silly. We let Sweden back into it and ultimately went in at 0-0. The second half started, and if I'm being honest, we just never really looked like going out to win the game. I think, I don't know what was said at halftime. Maybe Moreno was saying, we'll take the draw here. I really hope that wasn't said. I doubt it was, to be honest, but it is what it looked like. De Gea again was forced into some immense saves. There was a free header at the back post for Berg following a good Kajson cross. It then fell for Forsberg because Inigo Martinez and Bernat were half asleep, to be honest. De Gea, again, somehow manages to keep it out, but this time it skewers off his arms really weirdly, and Berg just bundles the ball in, literally from less than a yard out. And then all out of nowhere, Sweden have got their goal, and they've got exactly what they came for this game, and we let them do it. Of course we did, because we'll pass sideways, and then when a team gets a chance, we won't mark our men, we won't defend properly, and of course the goal comes from it. Apart from that, Sweden really did nothing in the second half. After they scored the goal, they had about two other efforts. De Gea made some smart saves again, but then he went off injured. Kepa had to come on for him, of course. Rodrigo also came on for Thiago in about the 65th minute, and also Navas came on really late for Dani Carvajal, which was, again, a really interesting substitution. I know what he was thinking, but, you know, when we need a goal, I don't know really what that was about. But we kept coming forward. A lot of passing sideways, though, I'm afraid. Sweden found it really comfortable to defend against us. Carvajal was getting in quite a bit, to be fair, but he then got removed, so that kind of stopped. And we got a chance in and amongst the air about the 77th minute. Moreno had a good header wide the post. Who else was it? Oh, yeah, Thabau had a really good chance to stab it beyond the goalkeeper, Olsen, but he was on fire. He made another good save. And it was about the 90th minute. The ball, it's a corner thinking, can we get to the Euros? Is this our moment? The ball gets whipped in here from Oyarzabal. It's a decent corner, flicked on by a Sweden head, I believe, Alexander Isak. It falls to Fabian, and you're thinking, we can really score here. It's all in about a couple of seconds. When it's at Fabian's feet as a Spain fan, you're really thinking, this is going to end up in a goal. And he flashes it across the box, and it's off Molino's leg, and it's into the goal, and it really was a mental moment. I'm not going to lie, out of all the negatives, it was a really beautiful moment. You know, you don't often get these international level, especially not in the qualifiers. Qualifiers, as you guys know, you know, you'll beat some poor opposition, and then the game that you qualify with will just be like a 3-0 home win to Lithuania or something. But to go out there against good opposition against Sweden and get a goal like that with a sub striker in the 91st minute, it was a beautiful moment. And he charges over to the bench. There were some Spain fans behind the Spain bench too. You know, Moreno's up and running. All the coaching staff are there. All of the subs are there. It's a massive hug in the corner there. And it was a beautiful moment. It was a really cool moment. It's a moment that you don't often see. And it was a lovely moment just to see that at the end there in what was a really horrible and frustrating game at time. So yeah, guys, full time. The game ends 1-1. We are in the Euros, but we need change. Moreno has to adapt. I still really trust in the man. I do think he's the right man to add a little bit of something different into this team. He's already proved it, but people are losing patience massively. And I just think he has to get himself back on side. He has to get the fans back on side. And he needs to pick better squads, guys. He does. We need more quality in the team. We need players like Alba back in the side. We need Ramos back in the team. We need to find Ramos' defensive partner. He needs to decide who's going to play at right back for us. He needs to let Busquets play ahead of Rodri. He needs to let Fabian and Ceballos make that midfield their own. Saul can come in there too. And up front, we need new options. I'm not going to lie, we need Ansu Fati. We need Ansu Fati. It sounds weird because he's 16 years old. But the guy's an absolute... He's a beast. He's so good, Ansu Fati. We need Ansu Fati. He can offer us a lot. He'll stretch defences. In games like that, he would have had a field day. He really would have. You know, ancient fullback like Lustig. But he literally had nothing to do because we weren't playing a left winger. So I just think we need new player profiles. Carlos Perez is another one of those. But I'm only talking about Barca players here. There are so many more pacey Spanish wingers who can get at players. And I just look at some of the players last night. Oyarzabal, someone who I'm quite excited by, but he looks scared playing for the national team right now. You watch him for Sociedad, and you watch him for Spain, and you're thinking, what on earth is going on here? It's like two different players. I don't know if he's out of position, if he's been given wrong instructions, not enough, you know, impetus from the coach. I'm not really sure what's going on there, but there are a couple of players who just look out of place, really, and you look at the team, you know, full of no disrespect. It's okay having Villarreal and Real Sociedad players, it really is, but the team's just full of players like that from, you know, mid-table La Liga teams, and that's fine if they're good enough, but I'm not really sure a lot of these guys are. We need some players back next international break, that's for sure. I want to see a really strong and competitive squad and a scary Spain squad. When you release squad lists like that, like we did this time, you just look at it and you think, yeah, okay, I like the idea. I think it's fair enough to give players who have played well last month their opportunity, but it's a bit ridiculous. You know, Norway and Sweden away, these are really two tough games that we should be going out there with a proper vintage Spain team and walking them off the park. And we're just going out there with mid-table La Liga players, full of them, riddled with them, the team, and passing sideways for 90 minutes. And I just think that we need more world-class and quality players on the side and a clear vision, guys, if we are going to get to the Euros and actually do something in them this time. But anyway, guys, Spain are in the Euros. I'll be seeing you guys next month for Malta at home and Romania at home. I'm hoping for a much better squad, a 4-3-3, players in correct positions, quality players, and we've made it to the Euros, though, guys. We have made it. It wasn't the easiest of groups, and they have done it, guys. Luis Enrique, Robert Moreno combining there as the coaches, and we have done it. We're in the Euros. It's a positive sign, and I'm happy. I am happy that we're there, but I just think that things really need to improve, and if they're not addressed, it'll be another disappointment for Spain. I can assure you that. I'm going to keep level-headed. We're going to keep coming back here, keep saying what's been right, what's been wrong, what needs to be done, who needs to be playing. And without any further ado, guys, hope you have enjoyed it. It's been a long review today. It's been quite a passionate one. And I'll see you guys next month for some more Spain videos. Until then, back for Barca and Chelsea. We're going to be at it again. And I'll see you then. Goodbye.